Hello and greetings from Iceland. I'm starting this update with what I would consider as big news, since the Met Office has just announced that there is a very high probability of an eruption in the next 3 weeks, and moreover, it might occur within the town, Grindavík. And this is a big bite to chew on, so before we go any deeper, I want to start with new information about the science debate I was talking about in my last update, also involving the Met Office. But three of our experts came to the conclusion recently that magma inflow into the magma chamber under Svartsengi had been gradually decreasing. And according to their calculations, this chapter by Grindavík would likely come to an end in 1 or 2 months. And they used the data from the Met Office to come to this conclusion. The Met Office didn't agree, so those experts were kind of swimming against the science mainstream for a while. But the mainstream media did well and they covered this. If not, I'm not sure if I would have found out about this. And then we finally got what we wanted from the Met Office. This plot showing that the magma inflow during the non-eruptive periods only is more or less proving those three experts are right. When this started, the inflow into the magma chamber was around 8 to 10 cubic meters per second, but it was down to 4 to 6 meters a second before the last eruption. However, the magma inflow is increasing again, so all bets are off. But why is this inflow fluctuating? There is always a chance that something was gradually blocking the system until the last eruption came to an end. But it's not for me to say, and I'm not sure if anyone can say. But I can, however, say that this is not getting any simpler. And it was right to listen to those experts who used their time to come up with this data presentation. But after all that work, it is frustrating to see this inflow increasing again, and it's bad news, especially since the Met Office is now coming up with this daring prediction about the location of the next eruption, or perhaps in the town itself, and they've also changed the timing from 3 to 6 weeks down to perhaps within 3 weeks, and today was actually the first day for a long time when I see the dike outlines through the 48-hour seismometer plot. I have not seen that on this plot since before the last eruption started. And this might have to do with the fact that the amount of magma already accumulated there has reached the minimum level to cause an eruption. But we also have to keep in mind that periods like this with minor seismic activity around the magma dike, they can go on for weeks. And the interval between eruptions has been growing longer, so I'm having a bit of a hard time seeing eruption number 9 take place in the next days. But I'm not the expert, and I might be missing something, like why the Met Office is expecting the next eruption to take place further south on the fissure, even within the town. And I was always under the impression that it would be highly unlikely to see such an eruption stretch so far south again, and then we have simple facts like the magma always finds the easiest way up, and we know where that path is already, so to see the magma break its way further south, it's somehow not logical, or if the channel that fed the last eruptions is still open. But again, the Met Office might know something that I don't know. I'm just saying how this looks to me. And this will not change my own plans. I was expecting the next eruption after 3 to 6 weeks, like the Met Office was talking about until just a few days ago. So I had planned to use the next 3 weeks to film many of our other volcanic systems on my list. The Icelandic summer is short, and this year it started late, and I've already been a bit on the move. Just one day tours so far, but the longer tours that I need to do, they are pending on weather and light conditions, and the weather forecast doesn't look good now. That has happened before. so I will just be following the light the next days. If the weather looks dull, I will spend some time in front of the computer. Plenty of work here, like I have a big video coming up about my channel and about my plans. I think you will like it, plus all the other videos from footage that I've already shot, but not found the time to edit it because I've been in and out of town, making the most from the Icelandic summer. So the weather will rule my uploads in the coming weeks, and when something starts to shake on the Reykjanes Peninsula, I will of course take off and stay in South Iceland in order to cover eruption number 9. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.